Yes, I want the police. Hello. I want to report that Christine Latham is leaving the state. She's on parole for a murder charge. She's got a little girl with her. You won't let them go, will you? Oh, God. Hey, that's our flight. Oh, Elizabeth, we've got to make this. We've got to. There she is.
Christine Latham. We'd like you to come down to the station with us, please. Answer a few questions.
I'll take the child.
No, please.
Now, don't be silly. There's no point in upsetting her by being so unpleasant.
Mother, mother, Brenda.
Oh, come on, now. Look, you don't want to bring her down to the station with you, do you? Come on.
Brenda, don't. Come on. No, please.
I'll take her out to the car. You get the luggage.
No, don't. I'm a mother.
Come on.
Well, are you ready for the big escape?
I guess so.
What time are you getting out?
I don't know.
Maybe Mrs. Morris will be able to
help. Well, nice to see Susie asking when she's getting out for a change.
All right, Lizzie, it's time you're out of there.
All right, I'm coming.
Mrs. Morris?
Yes, Susie.
Do you know what time I get out?
Straight after breakfast. Oh, well, don't look so happy about it. They might change their mind.
You'll go out that gate this morning, young lady, or I will throw you over the fence myself.
It's just a bit strange, that's all.
You'll get used to it.
Speaking of strange things, will you have a look at this?
Good Lord, what happened to you?
Nothing. I've got a splitting headache, that's all.
Oh, is it real bad, Lizzie?
I've had worse.
She's got a hangover.
Says who?
Says me. Come on, I know you pinched the rest of that booze. Now stop looking like death warmed up or the screws will throw you into the pound for sure.
Well, that's my business.
No, it's not. That hooch is not your personal project and you'll blow it for everyone.
No, I won't.
Well, you're right there. Come on, hand over the key.
What key?
The key to the boiler room.
There isn't any more.
Hand it over.
Ah, some people are too bossy for their own good. Just because I like a drop or two now and again.
You don't look very chirpy this morning.
No, I should be.
Why is that?
Do you remember my boyfriend?
Oh, don't tell me you split up again.
Yes, only this time it's for good. I wouldn't have him back if you paid me. Wentworth Detention Centre. Oh, yes, I'll tell Mrs. Davidson. Thank you. Oh, it's like homecoming week. Chrissy Latham's on her way back in.
That name rings a bell.
Oh, you weren't here then. Latham is the one who murdered Bill Jackson, Meg's first husband.
Oh, right. Yeah, I remember Meg telling me about it when Colin was having trouble with Carol Lewis.
Oh, I don't think this will be the same.
No, Meg's quite a different person.
Yes. Isn't she?
I bet you'll be glad that this is the last of this muck you'll be served up with.
Yep, it'll be real fresh eggs, crisp bacon and warm toast from now on for our girl.
I don't like crisp bacon.
Well, at least you'll have the choice.
We're both in the same company.
Ah, now there's another advantage to leaving this dump.
Well, you know what I mean.
Look, love, life goes on, and yours is going on right out of here. Thank God.
But mine is so different.
Well, I'll swap if you like.
Oh, good. Miss Lizzie. I didn't want to leave without saying goodbye to her.
Well, don't you worry. She won't let you go in without bending your ear at least one more time.
Hey, do you want to read the poem I wrote for the Weekly Stir?
All right.
I've got to get it. It's in my door.
Mm. That's dumb. Sure, it could be gone by the time you get back.
I never thought of that.
They ought to bag this muck and sell it to gardeners.
Well, aren't you in a good mood this morning? And where have you been?
I have friends in other places.
Mm-hmm.
How are you, love? All ready to go?
Yeah. I'm a bit nervous, though.
Oh, you'll be right. Once you get a chance to get out and cut loose for a while.
Not too loose, mind you.
It's all right, I'll behave.
Not much of a farewell, is it, love?
That's okay. I don't really feel like I'm going anywhere.
Well, you soon will. Here comes your eviction order.
Finished your breakfast, Susie?
Yes, Mrs. Morris.
Goodbye, love.
Bye-bye.
Take care of yourself, Suze.
You too.
What else can we do? Well, this really is the last. Goodbye, no?
I'll see you again.
No. We all love you, but no. Hey, come on, we've got work to do. Get out of here. Right, Susie, check everything before you sign for us.
Right.
Check it first.
But I know you wouldn't cheat me, Mrs. Morris.
That's not the point, Susie. You're on your own now. You've got to learn to look after yourself.
I know.
Now, here's your release money. I want you to count it before you sign for it.
Thank you.
So, you're off then?
Yes.
And here are your directions to the hostel. Put it somewhere safe.
I'll be all right, Mrs. Morris.
Of course you will. I'm just sorry I can't drive you there myself.
Really, I'll be all right. I've been on the outside before, remember?
Yes, we do remember. But you're not on the run now, Susie. Well, I think that's all. Good luck.
You've been really nice to me, Mrs. Morris. Would you say goodbye to Mrs. Powell?
Good luck, Susie. Can I see you to the gate?
Chrissy!
Who else?
I'll handle the induction if you want to see Susie.
No.
Christine Angela Latham.
Yes.
You've been remanded in custody on a charge of...
I know what I've bloody well been accused of.
All right, Chrissy. So there's no point in griping about it.
I knew you'd say that.
If you want life to be tolerable in here, then remember that.
I've got no ambition to get by in this thinking of. If it wasn't for that bloody sister-in-law of mine...
Are you saying you're innocent?
I'm saying I shouldn't have got caught.
Bloody hell, have a look who it is.
Well, must have felt homesick.
Yeah. G'day, Chrissy. What are you in for?
Oh, Doreen, you know better than that.
Just saying hello.
There'll be plenty of time for that later.
Yeah, too bloody much.
Oh, come along, Chrissy.
What's the charge this time?
It'll be disobeying an officer if you don't get back to work.
Yes, sir. Welcome home.
Does the laundry still pay the highest wages in this dump?
Yes, but the workshop pays the same now with the printing operation.
Can I start now?
Already?
Well, I'm allowed to, aren't I?
All right, then, I'll see what I can arrange.
Yes, dear, can I help you?
Mrs. Beamish?
Yes, that's right.
I'm Susan. Susan Driscoll.
Oh, yes, we've been expecting you. Please come in. Would you shut the front door, please?
Oh, sorry.
Is that all your luggage?
Yes, Mrs. Beamish.
Well, I don't suppose you would need very much in prison. But that's all behind you now that we have decided to give you a helping hand.
I never needed many clothes and things.
Of course not, my dear. After all, you were there to pay your debt. I understand you found some employment.
I got the job myself, at the chuck wagon. They advertise it on the radio.
Yes. Well, about your board?
I've got some money.
Good. The amount is $29 per week in advance. How much do you have?
$32.
Oh, dear. That's not leaving much for lunches and bus fares, is it?
I could always hitchhike.
Good gracious. No, Susan, I won't have my girls doing that sort of thing. Never mind. We'll reduce your board for the first week by $10. That should be enough until your first payday.
Thank you.
Right. Let's get you registered then.
Hey, didn't think we'd see Chrissy back in here again, not with the baby and everything. Do you reckon she's been back on the game?
How the bloody hell should I know? Here, ask her yourself.
All right, I know the way from here.
Hi, Chrissy.
Good day. Oh, hello, Dor.
Well?
Well, what?
Look, you've just arrived back in here. Don't you start playing funny buggers with me.
Oh, I wasn't, Bea.
What are you in here for, Chrissy?
Because of my sister-in-law, I got caught fiddling the doll. All right.
Pop goes one for all.
Hey, look, it's not a laughing matter.
Yeah, well, give us a few details and we'll make up our own minds about that.
She dobbed me in because she's a dried-up, ugly old cow who can't have a kid of her own, so she wants to pinch mine, don't she?
Well, how is Libby?
Elizabeth!
All right, Elizabeth, how is she? Oh,
she was just beautiful when I left her, till them bastard cops took her off me.
Why'd they do that?
Caught us skipping the state with the boss's money, and then she goes...
Hey, whoa, whoa, hang on. Doll fiddles, the boss's money, jumping parole. What other lurks have they got you for?
Ain't that enough?
I reckon it is. You bloody nong. How did you get lumbered with that lot?
Well, I wouldn't have if she hadn't have dobbed
yeah,
me in, would
yeah,
I?
Yeah, we heard.
Well, she's not getting away with it.
Well, what are you going to do about it, Chrissy?
Nothing she can do about it now.
You want to bet on it, Ben? They've taken away my little girl.
Oh, all right, cut the sob stuff. Sounds to me like you did a few stupid things yourself.
And what the hell do you think I was doing it for then, eh? For her, so I could get enough money to live with her on my own.
All right, fair enough, but don't complain when you get caught.
I'm going to find a way out of this. I can promise you that.
Yeah, well, if you ask me, you've got Buckley's with those charges against you. So just find a way of doing something useful while you're in here.
This is the room you'll be sharing. Now, it's nice and clean, and we'd like it kept that way. A place for everything and everything in its place. Oh, actually, Susan, the other bed is for you, dear. You'll find a list of house rules, together with the hours to be kept, on the door there. And you will be rostered with the other girls for communal duties, such as cleaning and kitchen assistance.
Who will I be sharing with?
Oh, a lovely young girl. Her name is Amanda Cole. Now, I want you to become very good friends with her, because she comes from a very respectable family.
Yes, Mrs. Beamish.
Well, I think that's all I can tell you for the time being. Just be a good girl, obey the rules, and I'm sure your stay here will be a happy one. Right, I'll leave you to settle in.
Thank you.
You look where you're going.
What are you standing there for?
I can stand wherever I bloody well want.
Well, you're supposed to be working, not standing around in everybody's way.
Shove it.
I'll shove you.
All right, you two, cut it out or I'll lean on the pair of you.
This place is about as much fun as a leaking dunny.
And what's eating you?
Nothing. Just Susie leaving, I suppose.
Yeah, I wonder how she's getting on.
Kicking up her heels and laughing, I reckon.
Is that that girl that left this morning?
None of your business.
Lay off. Yeah, did you see her?
Changed places with her, didn't I?
And don't we get all the bad deals.
Oh.
Where's Faye working?
Corridor, D block, why?
Think I might take the laundry trolley and go round and see her. Put a bed on, this place is getting on my nerves.
Want to put one on for me?
I'll do it yourself.
You can't both take the trolley.
I asked first.
And you can put a bet on for Chrissy while you're at it. I don't want any fighting in here unless I start it myself.
All right.
I'll have a dollar on Regal Lady then.
That nag. I'd do better with B on me back. Where's your money?
Right up front. There you go.
Where'd you get so much cash already? You just got here.
They do have real cash money in the outside world too, you know, Doreen.
Yes, I know that. And what else did you smuggle in?
Oh, shut up, Dor. Do you want the Earl of Wentworth to know about it?
Just being sociable.
She hasn't changed much, has she?
Doreen's all right. And none of us change much in here.
Any chance of some typing, Wendy?
Oh, not much until these are done.
What is it?
Oh, just an update on the illegal liquor search.
Oh, for the department?
Yeah.
Anything new in it?
Not a thing.
Well, why don't you change the date on the last one and send it in again?
Because someone might just read it.
Very unlikely. Oh, you need all that to say nothing has happened.
Well, I had to make it sound good.
Oh, I think you're a bit of a con man.
You just don't know me well enough. How about tomorrow night, then?
It'll be typed up by the morning.
I don't mean the report. I mean maybe dinner and a show afterwards.
Oh. Oh, all right.
Terrific. I can't tell you what the show is, but I'm sure you won't regret it.
No, but you will. You just knocked over the correcting fluid and it's all over your uniform.
Oh, damn.
Turn me back for a minute and you become some big-time journo. Yeah, how does it feel to be famous and all?
I'd hardly call it fame.
Oh, you get your name in the dispatch, give the department a bad time. I bet you get a real buzz out of that, don't you?
Well, I'm starting to lose interest, really. Helen and Susie are out. Judy will be out again soon. There's hardly any injustice left to crusade against.
You could write a little bit about me.
I'd hardly call that a crusade against injustice.
Hey, race is on.
Don't tell us to shut up until you at least find the station.
Well, so what are you going to write about then?
Oh, I don't know. What is there? The same pointless rules, pointless work, and the same soul-stuffing boredom.
In other words, bugger all. So why don't you write something about me?
Shut got it!
That was nearly finished.
Oh, shush!
Straightening at Houston Boy in front, but he's starting to weaken now with Blue Mist and Royal Oak grabbing him on the outside.
Come on, Royal Oak!
Regal Lady looking for a split, 50 metres left to go now. Royal Oak in front from Regal Lady and then Houston
Boy. Come on, Lady.
Regal Lady on the outside.
Go on!
Back, Royal Oak, Royal Oak in front, Regal Lady lunged at one.
Oh, yeah! Bloody nag should have started yesterday.
Oh, never mind, Dor.
You just haven't got the Latham touch, that's all.
Hello.
You must be Susie Driscoll.
Yeah. And you're?
Amanda Cole. So you're my new roommate then?
Yeah, I hope you don't mind.
Oh, no. I've been looking forward to meeting you ever since I read your story in the dispatch.
Oh, it wasn't that exciting. Well, just the way Bea wrote it.
Was it all true?
Oh, yeah.
Nothing like that's ever happened to me.
You're lucky.
Yeah, I suppose I am. There are some advantages to a quiet family life on a dairy farm.
Oh, it sounds lovely. Up in the country with your own family.
Yeah, I miss him a bit. Did you ever find your mum?
No. After spending half my life looking for her, I realised it wasn't worth it.
How come?
Well, she isn't looking for me, is she?
Yeah, I see what you mean.
Anyway, what's it really like in here?
Oh, it's okay, I suppose. There's too many rules and restrictions, but they don't bother me much with all my studies. Food's not too good either. But I suppose they mean well.
Do they let you out?
Oh, yeah, there's no problem there. Unless you're caught sneaking in late. But don't worry. You'll find it easy to fit in.
Yeah, I suppose I will. I've fitted in everywhere else.
Tomorrow night, eh? You don't waste any time, do you?
I try not to. I spilled correcting fluid on myself in the process.
Oh, well, I won't ask how. Here, let me have a look. Look, there's no one in the laundry at the moment. Here, why don't we go down there and see if we can find something to get it off with?
Good idea. Don't know what I'd do without you.
Just hope you're not this clumsy with all your love affairs. So it's dinner and a movie tomorrow night, eh? Soft music and candlelight.
Of course.
Do you mind?
Oh, sorry, Bea. Just seeing how the article's shaping up.
Yeah, well, it's not. I can't think of a bloody thing to write about. Dispatch isn't going to like this. There's no sensational scandal in it. Only the usual stuff about the rotten system and what it does to people.
Yeah, well, we already know about that.
Yeah, well, I know you know, but it'd be nice if a few people on the outside realised. Oh, what's the point? I try and make it as real as I can and no one's going to get to read it.
Hey,
guess what? You've been paroled.
Oh, don't be stupid.
Well, come on, what?
I just saw Mr. Faulkner with Mrs. M.
And?
They're on together.
Lizzie, what have you been drinking?
Nothing. It's true, I tell you. I just heard them talking about it.
Oh.
Well, the others believe me.
Come on, Lizzie.
All right. I know where they are. Right now, and what they're doing.
What?
Wouldn't be nice to say.
Of course not.
All right. But don't say you haven't been told. At least I try to share things with my mates.
Good for you, Lizzie.
Well, I mean, if I want to help...
No.
I am...
You are not getting that key, Lizzie. Not yet. You'll only go overboard and ruin it for everyone else.
All right. You can stick your rotten key because I've got...
What?
Nothing.
Well, there should be something in here.
I hope so. I can't afford dry cleaning this week.
Oh, I think this is it. It's not marked as usual.
So. What do you know?
What?
This stuff's designed for putting smiles on faces, not taking stains off jackets.
You mean it?
Alcohol. Pure homemade alcohol.
I thought we'd seen the last of this.
No wonder we didn't find it last time. It wasn't even hidden.
Well, until we uncover the source, there's going to be more popping up. It's just for their own safety. I mean, whoever hid that lot, they're crazy. One trace of dry cleaning fluid in a bottle and we'd have a death in our hands.
Well, as you say, the important thing is to find the source.
It's definitely homemade.
But not in Wentworth. I have searched everywhere.
Maybe we've overlooked
it. No, look, there is nowhere. You can't hide a still that easily, especially one large enough to make all we've uncovered.
Well, you could say the same thing about smuggling. How could they sneak in so much? Look, this is getting us absolutely nowhere. We'll have to have another cell search at once, although I doubt whether we'll find anything.
What do you want me to do with this, Mr. Davidson?
Pour it down the drain, Mr. Faulkner.
All right,
I'll organise the cell search.
Thank you. Oh, you'll need Mrs. Morris. She's in reception waiting for our new officer, Joan Ferguson.
Where do I sign on?
Joan Ferguson?
That's right.
Welcome to Wentworth. I'm Meg Morris.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, if you'd like to sign here, I'll take you through.
Yes. I must say, the place looks quite impressive from the outside. Not quite what I've been used to.
You've worked in prisons before?
Oh, yes, for many years, interstate.
Well, I'm afraid the guided tour is going to have to wait. We've got a cell search on.
Joan Ferguson, this is our deputy governor, Mrs. Colleen Powell.
Mrs. Powell?
Hello. We'll show you the run of the place after the search is completed.
Yes, well, I've studied your routine procedures, of course. It's only the prison layout I'm not familiar with. Oh, and of course the prisoners, but then I find they're the same all over. It's only the faces that change.
Yes, right. Well, let's get going. You're not expected to take a part in the search, but it'll give you a chance to see some of our faces while you observe.
Well, I don't mind getting straight into it. What are we looking for?
Illicit liquor, and possibly the still that made it.
Why do they keep having these cell searches? I'm sick of it.
Well, none of us are laughing, but you'd think grown people could find a better way to spend their time, wouldn't you?
Bloody screws are all warped.
What was that, Latham?
Oh, nothing, sir.
You could cut all this short, B.
How could I do that, Mr. Faulkner?
We found the booze you had hidden in the laundry. No, you don't have to dob anyone in. Just tell us where the rest of it is.
And how would I know that? Mind you, wouldn't be the first time a screw had smuggled a bottle of booze in here, would it? Have you thought of that?
Okay, that's where you want to play it.
He's a trier.
He's a bastard.
You lay off, Faulkner. He's done us a few good turns. For a screw, he's not all bad.
I'll try to remember.
You do that.
Shut up, Smith.
Bloody hell, will you have a look at this?
Oh, it looks so deceiving.
And that goes for everyone. Now just shut up unless you're looking for a charge.
You seem to have a few smart prisoners.
They need pulling into line at times.
Searches always make them a bit restless.
Of course. Mind if I join in?
If you like.
Well, I'm on salary. Might as well earn it.
I don't imagine we'll find anything in Latham's cell.
No, she's only been here today.
Oh, first time?
Oh, not Latham. This is her second home.
Well, let's see if she knows any of the old tricks. I thought so.
Well, I think you're going to fit in quite well here.
You wait till I get my hands on that Lizzie.
Do you think it's her fault?
Who else would hide booze in the laundry? She's going to get us all into trouble.
Listen, making that stuff wasn't exactly all her idea, you know.
Yeah, but running around and hiding all over the prison is all her own work.
She does get a bit carried away.
Yeah, not like looking at that new screw either. She's not going to be easy to fool.
No, you see the way that ape went through all my stuff?
Well, what did you expect?
Oh, no, they think they can do what they bloody well like. I don't have to like it, though, do I?
No, she looks like a real tough cookie to me.
Mm. Now, let's just play it by ear. Don't let her get on top of us. I don't like the way she's cotton onto Chrissy's heel so fast. That dame's been around.
You reckon she's another Vera?
Got the face for it. Well, let's talk about something pleasant.
Yes, that suits me. I'm going to need that poem today, honey. I'm setting up the Weekly Stir.
Oh, have you seen Bee's article?
No.
No, you won't want it.
It's real good, Jude.
Come on, we need it to fill the space.
Oh, suit yourself, but there's nothing in it you don't already know.
Hey, anyone want to place a bet?
Give over, Faye. It's only breakfast. Give us a chance to study the film before you scalp us.
And try and make it look like you're having a friendly conversation.
What do you mean?
We're in enough trouble already. We don't want to be copped for running a book.
Oh, sorry. Thing is, I'm stuck in the workshop all day. You want to go run it for me, Dor? Pays 5%.
10%.
Hey?
I'll do it.
You weren't asked.
Make a profit paying 10%. Margo never paid that much.
Yeah, I meant to talk to her about that. From now on, it is 10. Too big a risk for 5.
Okay, 10% on losing bets, 5% on winning. All right? Sounds fair to me. What do you reckon, Bea?
Yeah.
Good. See you later. I would have done it for 5.
No, Bea's right. If you get caught, it's going to be your head on the block, not Faye's.
I would have done it for 5 and all.
Oh, really? I heard you do it for nothing.
Joan Ferguson, our governor, Mrs. Davidson.
Pleased to meet you, Governor.
Welcome to Wentworth, Miss Ferguson.
Glad to be here.
I must admit, I was a little worried. The department usually sends us new recruits and we have to train them. But I can see from your file that I shouldn't have worried.
I hope not.
Actually, Joan came through this morning cell search with flying colours.
Good. Was anything found?
Nothing unexpected. Apart from a hollow heel and one of Latham's shoes. Empty, unfortunately.
Really? Old habits seem to die hard with Latham. Would you arrange for her to see me later this morning?
Certainly.
Now, I think we should give Miss Ferguson time to settle in after being rushed into the thick of things.
Thank you. I have just a few things to put away.
I've rostered you on reception duty after that.
Oh, good. Give me a chance to go through the files. Let me know who I'm dealing with. Pleasure to meet you, Governor.
Well, I think she's going to lighten the workload.
Her report from Queensland was excellent, and the department is very pleased with her. I think she'll prove quite an asset to us.
Don't they employ maids in Wentworth?
No, I'm the nearest you'll find here today. I've cleaned out a locker for you.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. Morris.
Some of us arranged to bring in our civvies if we want to go out after work.
Oh, I don't go for socialising very much, but I can understand the need for some people to unwind.
Yes.
What's the discipline like here?
Well, officers or prisoners?
Oh, prisoners, of course. I noticed a few of them almost stepping over the line today.
Well, at times they like to assert themselves, but generally speaking, they're well behaved. Of course, there's the usual pecking order, but you'd be used to that, I suppose.
Yes. I was going to ask, is there, only one bull in the yard? Top dog. Is there only one?
Oh, yes, yes. Well, she's been through some shaky periods, but Smith always comes out on top. Well, I'd better leave you, I suppose. Mrs. Davidson, I've got Chrissy Latham outside for you.
Well, do you think she'll tell us anything?
I doubt it. All she can think about is Elizabeth. Well, that's only natural, of course. But I'm worried she'll do or say something that'll only get her into more trouble.
Yeah. That attitude can be a worry. I'll be glad when she settles down.
Oh, we all will. Do you want me to go and get her?
Before you do, what was your impression of Joan Ferguson?
Oh, well, she seems to know her job.
You have reservations?
No, it's... She's just a little masculine, I suppose.
Yes, I understand, Meg, but we mustn't let that concern us. Her private life is her own affair, as long as it remains private and doesn't conflict with her work.
Yes, I know. I'm sure she'll be very good.
Good. Well, I suppose we'd better get Chrissy Latham in here and get that sorted out.
Come on, Chrissy.
Hello, Chrissy.
Mrs. Davidson.
I was hoping you'd throw some light on this show of yours.
Look, I've already told him I don't know nothing about it and I care even less.
You don't expect us to believe that.
Well, maybe the shoe was made that way. I don't know and I don't care. All I want to know about is Elizabeth. I'm entitled to know.
Well, you only had to ask.
Well, I'm asking, Mrs. Davidson.
I don't know what you're worried about, Chrissy. The department seem to think she's been well cared for.
In a home?
No, your sister-in-law is taking care of her.
That bitch, they're not going to leave her with her. They're
Chrissy.
Not.
The only alternative was an institution.
I'd rather have her on the streets than living with Brenda.
You can't mean that.
Don't you understand? All she wants is to take her off me.
That is a very complex legal process.
Stuff the legal
now, that
process.
That is enough.
Well, I can see I'm just wasting my time. I'll speak to you later when you've calmed down, Mrs. Morris.
Come along, Chrissy.
I want to see her.
Your sister-in-law?
No. My daughter. Please.
Well, I'll try to arrange it.
You must, Mrs. Davidson, please, you must. I just want to see her.
I'll phone if you like, Mrs. Davidson.
All right, then.
She's got to bring her in. She's just got to.
How about a flutter, B?
Well, thanks, but cheaper to give you the 10%. I'm not feeling lucky today.
Oh, go on. What about you, Phil?
Well, I'll give you Lizzie's bit, but I'm going to wait and see what Chrissy backs first.
God, not you too. God, you're a bunch of bloody sheep just because she fluked the winner yesterday.
She said it was a fluke. Anyway, here's Lizzie's dollar. She wants it on Black Rowan.
She was keeping clear of us.
Black Rowan, geez, that's the milkman's horse.
It's Lizzie's pick, not mine.
Watch it.
What are you backing, Chrissy?
Nothing. I'm not interested.
Oh, come on, you made a big killing yesterday.
Oh, yeah. I might retire on that.
Yeah, well, don't go quitting the game just because you're one jump ahead, because the rest won't like it.
Oh, all right. Put that on Argyle.
Oh, right. I'm an Argyle too, boy. What's this? You're backing it.
Looks like it.
Oh, well, may as well. They tell me it's going to Japan after the race anyway.
Good enough?
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Oh, well, don't give me too many compliments. It might go to my head. Well,
Bee's really outdone herself with this one.
Well, we talked her into it.
Congratulations, sir. The rest of the paper's not bad either. We'll make clothes out of you lot yet.
Oh, really, Mr. Faulkner?
You know what I mean. I'll take this to the governor and spread around some staff copies.
Okay, here you go.
So.
Have you seen Bee's article?
Oh, yeah, looks all right.
Uh-huh. Well, have you read it?
No, I'm waiting for Doreen to come in with the bits.
Listen, Faye, you can't go moping around here all the time while we do all the rest of the work, waiting for Doreen to come back, seeing how much money she's conned out of everyone.
That's not fair. And if Doreen doesn't come soon, it'll be too late for the first race.
And what difference does that make? If a bet's on, isn't it?
Well, I want to know.
Oh, God, you're a lazy bugger. Here, look. Read this. You might learn something. All right, girls, come on, let's take a smoker. I don't see any point in me slogging myself out while Madam Rich gets richer.
Yeah, how'd you go? Well, I've got a dollar on Black Rowan and 24 on Argyle.
That's a 20 to 1 outside Australia. I made a packet.
If it loses.
Oh, we'll clean up on this, no worries.
How much you got in the bank now?
Nearly 500, I reckon.
Oh, seems like easy money to me.
There you are, Julie.
Yes.
How's it going, Joan? Make good reading?
Oh, not bad. We've got quite a record here. 11 escapes last year, one suicide, the murder of a visitor, and a riot in which you were held hostage.
You have been doing your homework.
Yes, well, I like to know what makes a place tick. Which prisoner's file would you recommend for close study?
Well, that's easy. Bee Smith's at the centre of most things in Wentworth.
Ah, yes. Smith. Well, I'd better start with her. Uh-huh. I'll read about our famous top dog whilst I'm at lunch. Mrs. Morris?
We've got a keen one there.
How do you mean?
She's reading files during her lunch break.
Oh, dear. We'll have to smarten up our footwork, won't we? Get me Brenda Latham on that number, please, Julie.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Scandal in high places. Extra, extra, sex and boredom. Buy your free copy here, girls. Extra, extra, hot off the press.
Now, was it really worth all that hoo-ha?
I don't think so. I got nothing else to shout about, though.
Excuse me. What do you think of your article in print?
Didn't like it when I wrote it. Don't see why I should like it now.
Well, it's the best thing in the paper.
These the first copies, Jude?
No, Faulkner took some down to the staff room half an hour ago. Well, after all that, I'm going to risk a meal.
Hey, your article looks good in print, B.
Yeah, as long as you don't get close enough to read it. Still should be tame enough to get past day, but...
Oh, I liked it the first time I read it. Yeah.
You finish your meal, B?
This meal was finished before I started it.
Mrs. Davison likes you.
What, are you going to tell me why?
You'd have to ask yourself.
Oh. Love this place. So much free information.
Where are you off to?
I'm being taken to our leader.
Oh. What's all that about?
You know, Davo wants to see her. Maybe Bea's in strife.
She wouldn't be onto the book, would she?
If she was, she would have asked to see you, wouldn't she? How is the book, though?
Oh, great. And I've just been going a little while and I've got nearly 500 in the bank.
Oh, I wouldn't spread it around too much if I were you. Your lamp would go bust.
Oh, yes.
How'd you get on?
Oh, real good. Elizabeth's coming in, the Sava.
Well, your sister-in-law can't be that bad now, can she?
I know what she is, Jude. And I'm going to tell her and all when she gets here.
Come in.
I have just been reading your article.
Girl, that's the weakest thing I've ever written. You're not going to censor that, are you?
No, I'm not. And I disagree with your description of the article. It's a well-written, sensitive piece of journalism.
Are we talking about the same thing?
We are. The article is thought-provoking and to the point. I think the Dispatch would be very happy to get it.
Oh, all they're interested in is sensationalism and scandal, which definitely rules that out.
Mr. Faulkner.
It's the best so far, Bea.
Well, it might be right as a writing exercise, but I don't want it sent anywhere. It's not wanted.
Would you permit me to send it to the Dispatch for you?
Oh, please yourself. It's a waste of stamps, you ask me.
Oh, what's going on, then?
Well, shut up. We're trying to listen.
Well, are they out of the stalls yet or not?
Just about.
How much you got riding, Doreen?
Dollar.
On what?
Same as you.
Well, don't blame me if it loses. I've got no interest in it.
Oh, here it comes.
They're ready now for the Oakland's handicap, waiting on starter's orders. Ready? Racing and June Echo have got away to a good start.
Screw!
Good afternoon. Nice to see you all so busy.
Yeah, there's always something to do.
Good. I'm Officer Ferguson. You're seeing a lot of me from now on. Where's B. Smith?
She went to see the governor.
I understand she's top dog amongst you prisoners. How did she earn that privilege?
I don't know.
Strange. Everybody else seems to know all about the famous B. Smith, except the people who work with her.
Why don't you ask me? I know all about her.
Smith?
That's right. So what?
Just getting my bearings.
I don't think we've been introduced.
Your friends will tell you who I am. Bad news, eh?
That bloody thing was a rank outsider and half of Wentworth backed it. By the time I've paid out in this, I'll be broke. $500 and now I'm broke.
Well, when are we getting our money?
It's not up to me. I've got to talk to Faye.
Well, get your trolley, Doreen. I got $18 coming to me.
So what's the big rush? You lot aren't exactly going anywhere in a hurry. And the bookie can't skip town.
Might as well get it over with. I'll go and see you now, eh?
Beauty. You're a bloody marvel, Chrissy.
Well, there's someone who's not gloating.
I haven't had my visit from Elizabeth yet, have I?
Oh, yeah, sorry, I forgot about that.
I'm going to find a screw, see what's gone wrong.
Hang on. If you shoot through out of here, there's not going to be enough of us left. And it'll be risky with me with the trolley.
Well, it's too bad, Dora. I've got to find out what's happened to her.
Does this mean we've got to wait for our money?
Bugger, Chrissy, I wanted to get it over with now.
Oh, you lot are all bloody heart, aren't you? Her kid is more important. You can get your money any time.
Just hold it right there. Why aren't you at work?
I just want to find out about my little girl's visit.
You have to settle on the book, you mean? I'm not stupid.
What are you talking about?
Well, the race is over and the bookie's runner starts running.
Oh, for God's sake, it's got nothing to do with the bloody book. I just want to know about my visit.
So you said.
I have got a right to know.
Don't you quote your rights to me in that tone.
What's the problem?
No problem.
Mrs. Morris, what's happened to my visit then?
I really don't know, Chrissy. Your sister-in-law seemed quite happy about it when I spoke to her.
Well, where the hell is she then?
Well, there's no need to get upset about it. I'll phone her back and see what I can do.
Thanks.
You finished with her, Miss Fix?
Yes, you seem to have solved that quite well, I think.
Right, go back to work, Chrissy, and I'll let you know. She's upset about her child.
Of course. Who wouldn't be?
There's still a lot to be done, but when the work's finished, she should be great. I must admit, I'm starting to get excited about it.
Well, with a project that big, I'm not surprised. Still, I suppose all sailors feel that way about their ships, boats.
Probably.
You're doing all the work yourself?
Most of it. Well, Meg's lent a hand. She's becoming quite a pro with the old paintbrush.
Oh, woman of many talents.
Yeah, she certainly has a few of those. Well, better get back to work.
No answer, damn it. What's happened to her?
Now, come on, what is all of this about you and young Steve?
Oh, now, don't you start. Lizzie's already got some of the women believing there's wedding bells in the distance.
Really?
And I can do without it. Off duty, Steve's a very pleasant person, and that is all.
I do believe you, Meg. Can I have a coffee?
Some of us have to work.
Touché.
Hi, Dora, and how's the happy little washerwoman this afternoon?
Wish that was all I was today.
You and me both.
Some of the women are asking for their money.
Oh, bloody hell, they can't wait, can they? First bloody race and they clean me out.
Yeah, well, it's the luck of the game, isn't it?
You got the money, haven't you?
Only just. I should pay shorter odds on a horse like that with everybody backing it.
Oh, come on, you got to be kidding. You don't give them starting prices, they're going to skin you alive.
Well, next time you get the bright idea of selling everybody in the same horse, do it with your own money.
Well, it wasn't my fault. They were all following Chrissy.
Someone sure as hell jinxed me. Look, here's the payout list.
You pay out everybody?
Of course I do. I'm paying you enough, aren't I? You might as well earn it. And don't bugger up the payout.
Gotta hand it to you, Faye. Anyone else would be really upset about losing that much money.
She's quite happy while they're losing. Now, of course, if they're winning, she's blaming me. She says I'm jinxing it.
Where are you off to, Burns?
I was just taking the dirty linen to the laundry.
My name is Miss Ferguson, and you will stand up straight when you speak to me.
Sorry, Miss Ferguson.
Are you now? Seems to be a lot of wasted effort collecting this dirty linen.
What do you mean?
Well, the basket is only quarter full. You could collect more and make less trips. So I must ask you, Burns, what it is you're really doing wandering around the corridors.
Well, I already told.
Get over against that wall. Put your arms up. Keep them there.
I haven't done anything.
Shut up. Put your arms down.
I go now?
No.
Give me roses, I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain as to when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare.